Today we're going to be talking about Cozy by Lewis Naura. Today we'll be covering summary and themes, but if you stay until the end of this video, I'll show you where you can go and get sample essay topics, including a sample essay topic breakdown that you can go away and practice with. I think it's always super important that you understand that you're studying English, not just for English sake, but that these ideas are actually relevant for your real life. And so I'll be linking a lot of the ideas to modern real life examples so you can get a better understanding of this text. Hey guys, welcome back. If you're new here, I'm Lisa. I was a shoddy English student, turned A plus student, turned pharmacist, turned entrepreneur. So on this channel, we talk about study and life advice to get you prepped into adulthood. Let's get into it. Summary. How would you feel if you were thrown into the deep end at a new job with a bunch of clients, no training, and a super absent boss? It would most likely feel like an impossible task and you'd have no idea where to start. I'm sure some of you may have experienced a similar situation, whether in your career or personal life. Everyone feels uncomfortable at one time or another. It's a part of life. You've probably experienced this too, but it's these challenging times that we experience that actually help to grow us as a person. This is essentially what Cozy is about. Lewis is faced with a seemingly impossible task, to bring order to the chaotic world of the asylum. Yet in the process of doing so, he develops hugely as a person. Although, it's important not to take Lewis's development at face value. His growth is used to highlight many of Naura's values on issues surrounding love, fidelity, madness, and reality, just to name a few. It's also important to look at the development, or lack of development, of other characters and think about why Naura might have included them in the play. Luckily for you, Cozy is quite a short play and doesn't have a huge cast of characters. However, this means that it's even more important to get a great understanding of each character. They're all there for a reason. Themes: fidelity and infidelity. According to Mozart's Cosi fan tutte, fidelity is depicted as an ideal that is never achieved. The interpretation of Cosi fan tutte is that women are like that. Mozart supported the belief that men should simply accept that women would inevitably be disloyal in relationships. Talk about misogyny, right? Naura echoes this view of women through Lewis and Lucy's relationship. While Lucy is sleeping with Lewis, she's also triflingly having sex with Nick. When Lewis discovers Lucy's betrayal, she waves aside his shock, defending herself. It's not as if we're married. The revelation thus does prove Mozart right. That women's constancy is like the Arabian Phoenix. Everyone swears it exists, but no one has seen it. Although the women in both Cozy fan tutte and Cozy are shown to be unfaithful, so are the men. While the men in Cozy fan tutte do not actively participate in adultery, they do fabricate their departure to the war and also disguise themselves as Albanians. Their deception thus is also a betrayal to their wives. Meanwhile, Don Alfonso manipulates everyone. As seen in Cozy, Lewis is unfaithful to Lucy as he kisses Julie during rehearsals. Julie later reveals that she has a girlfriend who she would prefer to be with, confirming that both men and women are unfaithful in relationships, despite whatever values they may claim to have. Naura considers many perspectives of love and fidelity without offering a definitive opinion. Instead, he explores the progression or stagnation of characters' opinions on love and contrasts them to those of other characters in the hope of highlighting its complexity. Nick and Lucy both view love as an indulgence that is incompatible with politics and secondary to life's basic needs. Whereas Lewis claims without love, the world wouldn't mean that much. These differences between Nick and Lucy's view on love and Lewis are major contributors to the deterioration of their relationships. Therefore, Naura shows that communication and truthfulness are needed for healthy and reciprocal relationships. Think about the relationships you have in your own life or the relationships you see some of your close ones having with others. What are those relationships like? How is the love built and how is the trust built? Have you seen relationships where that trust has been broken and what has it meant for these people? Overall, while Cozy fan tutte presents love and fidelity as wavering, Naura provides a more practical view of love. Naura suggests that love is complex and cannot be fully understood or tamed. instead portraying it as an akin to madness. As love is universal, this view ties in nicely with his non-judgmental perspective on madness and insanity. Sanity and insanity. The line between sanity and insanity is explored through the juxtaposition of the patients and society. In the 1970s, those who behave abnormally were declared to be insane and placed in mental institutions that were shunned by society. As scientific developments have now informed us, these environments often fail to assist their patients. The use of electric shock therapy, for example, frequently led to severe, long-term negative effects upon patients. It's really important here to remember that back in the day, some of the systems and regulations that we have in modern time health were not in place. So really terrible treatments like shock treatment therapy, where there are a lot of unsafe and secret experiments being held, were surprisingly more common than one would think. We've learned a lot since then, but this was a period when mental health was still an enigma of sorts. Although there had been massive progressions in mental health understanding, it's nowhere near what we understand of it now. I mean, think about it. Mental health back then was shunned by society. If you had mental health issues, you were ostracized and you were locked away into essentially a prison of sorts. Whereas these days we have so much more support. We have mental health hotlines. We have psychiatrists and psychologists who are no longer as taboo as they used to be. Mental health is something that's discussed openly and acceptingly. While the patients were viewed as madmen by outsiders, Lewis soon discovers that they were, in many ways, ordinary people. Although each patient has a mental flaw, all possess interesting opinions and beliefs on different matters. Additionally, Nara encourages his readers to view insanity as more complex than a diagnosis or something that can be fixed with a coat of paint. Instead, he suggests that insanity is imposed on people through the judgment of others. Nara also attempts to blur the lines between sanity and insanity to emphasize the indiscriminate nature of madness. By the way, if there are new pieces of vocabulary that you find in this video, I highly recommend that you write them down and save them for your essay writing later. That's just a hot tip for you, but do make sure that you understand the word before you actually go and use it. This is seen through Lewis's character, who consistently bridges the gap between madness and normalcy. For example, despite his quote-unquote sane status, he is mistaken for a patient by Justin, joins Roy in imitating electric shock therapy, replaces Doug in the play, and stands with the patients against Justin. Overall, Nara portrays insanity as a matter of perspective, rather than an objective diagnosis. He refuses to define madness, instead depicting it as somewhere on the spectrum of human behavior. In doing so, he criticizes traditional perspectives of sanity and insanity, and instead encourages his audiences to consider the complexity of madness. If you're enjoying my teaching, then I think it's a good time to link you to a few extra resources that you'll probably find helpful as well. We won't cover all the themes in this video today, but if you wanted to learn more about themes, including misogyny, learning and self-development, essay topics that you can go away and practice with, then I'll recommend you head over to my blog to read more. And if you wanted that extra bit more, then I highly recommend you my study guide, COSI. In this guide, I cover all the things we talk about today, everything that's in the blog, and what you might find even more helpful is that we've taken 5 of the essay topics and actually written them up with full annotations so that you can see inside the mind of a high achiever. I'll link those resources for you in the description box. Let's keep going with the last theme, reality and illusion. The question of what is real or what is an illusion is weighed through the patient's state of mentality. As shown through Ruth, who struggles to pretend like she is having real coffee on stage, it is difficult for some to distinguish reality from illusion, even if it's clear to everyone else. For others, they may willingly refuse the truth and succumb to an illusion. Lewis deluded himself into believing that Lucy was faithful when all signs, such as Nick residing in the same home and Nick and Lucy spending time together, indicated that Lucy was, in fact, blatantly disloyal. Much like Lewis's protective delusion, Roy uses illusions of a happy childhood to shield him from facing his reality. This builds upon his tendencies to blame others for his behavior. He's inherently unable to face the truth of his insanity and also manipulates his reality to make it more bearable. Throughout Cozzi, Nara also explores the relativity of reality. For the patients of the asylum, pretending to give electric shock therapy to others seems realer than kissing and stuff, whereas the opposite would be true in ordinary society. However, Cozzi also suggests that imagination has the capacity to empower. Through participating in the play, which is an illusory form of reality, the patients are able to explore their views on love and commitment. Ultimately, the behavior of characters such as Roy and Ruth encourages us to consider the reliability or unreliability of our own perceptions. Alongside this, Nara stresses the importance of being able to accept your own reality, as he shows that characters who fail to do so also fail to experience personal growth, like Roy and Julie. Pretty deep stuff, right? I recommend you now head on over to my playlist where I've got tips on essay writing and essay structure for you, because it's highly likely that you'll need to know a lot of these tips and advice for when you're ready to start writing on Cozzi. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!